So it appears if you've updated Adobe Bridge, there's a new way to do contact sheets. So for me, I'm getting both options still, but another student was only able to see the new option. But it is a better option. So I'm going to create a new video for you. So if you get stuck and can't figure out how to do a contact sheet, this is the new way to do it. Or if you just want to switch over, even if you have access to the old way, this way is actually much faster and will create a single PDF document no matter how many images you have. Or how many pages, it'll just combine it into one PDF document. So it's actually a bit better and kind of like the old way Bridge used to do it, which was a lot more efficient as well too. So first thing you need to do is go to your workspaces. So up at the top right hand here, typically I work in the Essentials workspace, but in order to do this, you need to go into the Output workspace. So just go down your list of workspaces here, choose Output, and you'll see you get some new options here. So your photos have moved down to the bottom. So you just have to select all the ones that you're going to put in there. I don't have that many here. So I'm just going to move over, hold down the shift key at the last one, and that's going to highlight them all. Up here, it's giving me page sizes, kind of similar to the dialog window we had before. So it gives me page sizes, but at the top here, it tells me how many images per page. So you can do a custom one, but I found it a bit tricky. So I'm going to suggest just doing 4 by 5. So that's going to give you 20 pictures per page, and it's easier to do this way, so you're not going to have to worry about creating lots of big contact sheet documents in Photoshop. It's all going to be done here in Bridge. So choose the 4 by 5. That'll give you 20 pictures. It makes them a bit bigger, and it's actually a bit easier for me to see anyway. So choose 4 by 5. The page size is A4, which is a standard sort of letter size page. Make sure the resolution here is still at 300 dpi, so I can blow them up and see the details better. And then it's just a matter of dragging these images that you've highlighted here onto the page. So I'm just going to drag them up and it's going to add them just like that. So now all I have to do is output this. So right at the bottom, you'll see export to PDF. And if I just hit that, it's now going to create a PDF page without ever going into Photoshop. And I can title it here. So just tell test contact sheet. It's already creating a PDF right away. I just need to choose where I want it to go. I'll just put it onto my desktop. Click Save. And it's creating it. And that's it. And it's done. And it's going to open up. For me, it's going to open up right away in Adobe Acrobat. It might open up for preview or it might not open up at all. But in my case, it's opening up. And there it is. So much faster and more efficient way to do it. So I would suggest doing this way when you create the contact sheets for your studio portraits or any other assignments that you have to do this for. It seems to be a much better way of doing it. Okay. Thanks for watching.